AC means, okay, AC current means it is not direction sensitive, okay, because during the positive half cycle the current will flow upward, during the negative half cycle the current will flow downwards. To indicate that in the first, okay, in the very beginning where the current is flowing, to indicate that they'll use this arrow mark, or sometime they'll use this plus minus also, okay, so don't get confused, because but really there is no plus minus for AC signal, okay. AC signal is not direction sensitive, okay. You know from your experience, okay, in our house applications we can flip the flux, okay, then also the device will work, let it be fan or bulb, anything. So that means what, AC is not direction sensitive, okay. AC is not direction sensitive, but whereas DC is direction sensitive, okay, is not direction sensitive. That means you can flip the terminal, plus minus, no problem, because always the current will be flowing in both the direction, okay, because in each cycle there is a positive current and there is a negative cycle, okay. During a positive half cycle the current will flow in one direction, during negative half cycle the current will flow in the opposite direction, okay. Now once okay, so once the AC signal is applied to the resistor, once the AC signal is applied to the resistor, okay, the AC signal value I take like this, V is equal to Vm, okay, some maximum value sin omega t, okay, V is equal to Vm sin omega t. Then I bar is the current through the circuit, okay. You know V is equal to, from Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, okay, V is equal to IR. If it is V bar, this is I bar, then I bar is equal to V bar divided by R, okay, then Vm sin omega t divided by R. This Vm divided by R I can write it as Im, okay, then finally this is Im sin omega t, okay. So finally I bar is equal to Im sin omega t, okay. So what is happening, you take some current Vm sin omega t, sorry, some voltage, once if you apply that voltage across the resistor, okay, you are getting some current, that is Im sin omega t. That sin omega t and the sin omega t remain same. That means what, finally there is no phase difference between the voltage and current, okay. So the phase difference, the phase difference is 0 degree, the phase difference is 0 degree. That means what, both current and voltage is having the same phase, okay. That means when there is no phase difference, okay, phase difference, okay, phase difference between voltage and current, when there is no phase difference, okay, then there is no delay, okay, there is no delay between current and voltage, okay, between the current and the voltage, because as soon as you apply the voltage the current will be produced, okay, there is no delay. And also it indicates that there is no memory, okay, because you are getting the delay in case of inductor and capacitor, because it is the inductor and capacitor is like a memory element, because it can store the energy, later it will give it back. But this resistor will simply dissipate the energy, okay, even though the source is DC voltage or the source could be AC voltage, whatever may be, the resistor will simply dissipate the power, okay. So that means finally what the conclusion we are having, there is no phase difference between the voltage and current, okay, then there is no delay, then there is no memory. That means what is the conclusion here, the resistor behaves in the same way for both AC and DC, okay. Let it be AC or DC, if you give the DC signal, corresponding DC current it will produce, if you give the AC signal, corresponding AC current it will produce, but it will not introduce any delay. Okay, it will not introduce any delay. Okay, so the resistor behaves same way for both AC and DC. Same way for both AC and DC. But this may not be true for inductor and capacitor. Okay, that nature is really different. That we'll see. Next, what is the power? Okay, so what is the power dissipated by the resistor, because this is not the DC voltage source, this is the AC voltage source. But even though this is AC voltage source, now some AC current is flowing finally. Then finally what is the power dissipated by the resistor? okay, power dissipated by the resistor. Okay. Okay, now I take some voltage, sinusoidal voltage source. I take some voltage source like this. Next, again, current is I is equal to Vm divided by R, maximum current. Okay, I maximum current is equal to Vm divided by R. Once if we consider the maximum value, then R is something, some really positive value, then current will be lesser. Okay, so my current is flowing like this. It may flow like this, but there is no phase difference that you have to observe. Amplitude difference may be there, but there is no phase difference. Okay, so the first black one is like a voltage. Okay, now this is the voltage across the resistance. Okay, now this is the current through the resistance. Okay, this is the current through the resistance. Now, then what is the power? Power means always product of the voltage and current. Okay, so if you concentrate on the first cycle, both are positive. Okay, then once if you multiply these two, you'll get something like this. Okay, so you'll get the curve like this. Okay, both are positive, then you'll get the curve like this. Then in the second half cycle also, both are negative. Then that means what is your power? Then this is your power. Okay, so finally what you are getting for power, you are getting nature something like this. Okay, something like this. Then once if this is the waveform, power waveform, then you can find out what is the average value. Okay, because this is like a AC, because it is increasing, then decreasing, and again increasing, decreasing. So on an average, you can tell some value that is the average power. Okay, P average. Okay, so now once again for this waveform, if you calculate, okay, and again this is the maximum power, but we need average. Okay, we need average. Okay, this may be P average. Okay, then how to calculate this P average? Okay, how to calculate this P average? Okay, that is the next idea. And again, this power is really dissipated by the resistance. It cannot be recovered back. As soon as the voltage is applied, current flows across the resistor, then there will be the power dissipation. Instantaneously, there will be the power dissipation. Instantaneously, there will be the power dissipation. And then this final one is like a power waveform. This is power waveform. Okay, and this is called as actual power. Okay, dissipated by the resistance. Okay, this power is called as active power or real power. Okay, this power is called active power or real power. Okay, and then it is denoted in watts. The unit for this one is watt. Okay, really dissipated by the resistor. That means equivalently some other work is done in the some other domain. Okay, so in watt. Okay, now next, how to find out this P average? Okay, how to find out this P average? Before that, I'll write the phasor diagram for resistor. Phasor diagram. Phasor diagram here is the phasor diagram means the relationship between the voltage and the current across the resistance. Okay, so if the voltage is like this, then the current will be like this. Okay, both are in the same direction. Okay, but IR value is less than VR because you know I is equal to V by R. That's why less magnitude I am taking for IR. But the phase difference here is zero. Okay, what is phi indicating always? Phi means phase difference between the voltage and current across a particular element. If it is a resistance, okay, then okay, IR, VR. If it is a inductor, IL, VL. If it is a capacitor, IC, VC. Something like that. Okay, so what is phi? Phase difference between the voltage and current. Okay, phase difference between voltage and current. Okay, phase difference between the voltage and current. Now the phase difference is zero. Once the phase difference is zero, once if you know the phase difference, then you can calculate the power factor. Okay, you can calculate the power factor. That power factor formula is equal to cos pi. Okay, cos pi. Now cos zero, so the power factor is unity. So this is called as unity power factor. Okay, so the resistor is having unity power factor. Okay, the resistor is having unity power factor. Okay, next, how to calculate the power? Okay, P average. The P average is equal to, and again we are calculating the average power. Okay, because again, once if you calculate the average power, you can take any one of the cycle. Okay, you can take any one of the off cycle. Okay, then 1 by T integration 0 to t, what is the voltage there, what is the current there, Vt, It into dt, and once you substitute these values 0 to t, t, voltage means Vm sin omega t, Im means Im sin omega t. And you know that sin omega t is like a sin square omega t. It's something like sin square theta. Sin square theta can be replaced by 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. So I will replace this with 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. Okay, so that 2 I will take out. Okay, or otherwise you can write here itself. Vm, Im I have already taken out. Anyway, t is there. Okay, 0 to t. This is 1 minus cos, okay, 2 omega t divided by 2. Okay, then once if you apply the integration here, you'll get again tt will cancel, you'll get 1 by 2 from the first part. The second part will become 0. Okay, you take this as an exercise and then do it yourself. The second part will become as a 0 and tt will cancel, the 2 will come out. So finally Vm, Im divided by 2 is the answer. Okay, so you have to be very careful here. I am not using Vi, okay, I am using Vm, Im. Okay, and again this formula can be modified like this. Okay, I can also write this formula with Vrms and Irms, because you know for the voltage waveform, if you take Vrms, Vm divided by root 2, for current waveform if you take Vrms, Vm divided by root 2, and that also finally giving you Vm, Im is equal, that also finally giving, this is Vm, Im, so Vm, Im divided by 2. Okay, so whenever you want to calculate the power for AC signal, you have to be little bit careful, okay? Just like that, you should not multiply V and I, then your answer is wrong. Okay, if you multiply like that, your answer is wrong. So what you have to do, and you have to either use Vrms, if it is Vrms, Irms, directly you can multiply. Okay, if it is given in terms of the maximum voltage, then you have to put by 2. Okay, you have to put by 2, then or otherwise your answer will be wrong. If you are not following this notation, your answer will be wrong. So you have to be very careful when you calculate the power for AC signal. Okay, when the voltage is applied, when the AC voltage is applied across the resistance, to calculate the power, you have to be very careful. So in future, always remember, whenever you want to calculate the AC power, you always remember this idea. Okay, always this has to be in this format. Okay, this has to be in this format. RMS, if it is RMS value, then directly you can multiply, or otherwise you have to apply the formulas, by 2 formula. Okay. So finally, what is the unit here? The final unit is watt. Okay, final unit is watt. Okay, next we'll take inductor. Okay, so what we have observed, when the AC signal is flowing through the resistance, it simply dissipates the power. How much power is getting dissipated, that is given by this formula. And also we have seen there is no phase difference between the voltage and current. Okay, so then there is no delay between the voltage and current. Okay, as soon as you apply the current, the voltage will be developed, or as soon as you apply the voltage, the current will be developed. There is no phase delay. That's why here the power factor is unity. Power factor is unity. Later we'll see what is the importance of the power factor. Okay, next one is inductor. Inductor. Once if you connect AC signal to the inductor, how it is behaving? Inductor is there, AC signal voltage, okay, so plus minus, this is the inductor L, this is the current, okay, I vector, and again once if I apply V vector, the same voltage only will appear across this inductor, because the voltage source and the inductor are in parallel, and again the same current will be flowing through both the voltage source and as well as the inductor. Okay, now we'll see one by one. Now suppose if the current nature is Im sin omega t, you know that once if current is like this, then voltage across the inductor is equal to V is equal to L di divided by dt. Okay, then once if you apply the differentiation L Im omega cos omega t. Now again L Im omega, this cos omega, because I applied sin omega t, my current is sin omega t, but my voltage becoming as cos omega t. So somehow I'll try to represent cos omega t in terms of sin omega t, so that I can compare. Okay, so this cos omega t is something is equal to sin omega t plus 90 degree, sin omega t plus 90 degree. Okay, or otherwise I can write in different format, this L Im omega sin omega t, instead of 90 degree I can write j also. If it is plus 90 degree I can simply write j, if it is minus 90 degree I can simply write minus j. Okay, both are same. Okay, and this is v bar, so v bar is equal to omega L Im. Okay, Im, if I write this j here, okay, then rest of the thing is sin omega t. Now v bar is equal to j omega L, this Im sin omega t, I can write it as I bar. Okay, I can write it as I bar. Finally, I am getting the relationship between the current and voltage. Okay, so I know voltage divided by current. Okay, this is the voltage, this is the current, then this is something, it is phasing. Okay, voltage divided by current means something, some impedance is offered by this inductor. Okay, so, and again I can call it as a impedance offered by the inductance. Okay, that is ZL. Okay, ZL, ZL bar, because that could be complex. Okay, that's why ZL bar. Then again, ZL bar value is j omega L simply. Okay, ZL bar value is j omega. Or otherwise, I can also write like this, j into XL, j into XL. Okay, XL means just impedance value. Okay, impedance resistance value. Along with that, you are adding either plus j or minus j. Okay, either that is upward or either that is a positive reactance or it is a negative reactance. Okay, so ZL is equal to j omega L or j XL, where XL is equal to omega L. Now what is this XL is equal to omega L? What is this unit? Somebody asks, the unit is ohm only, without any doubt. What is the unit? The unit is ohm only. Okay, now I am not having any resistance here, but when I connect a inductor, okay, when I apply some voltage source, then it is acting like a resistance, but that resistance is depending on the frequency. That resistance is depending on the frequency. That means what? When I increase my frequency, because finally my current, okay, when I increase my frequency, my XL will increase. If my XL increases, what will happen? Okay, the impedance offered by this inductor increases, then my current will decrease. Okay, so what will happen if this increases? Okay, now because you can write this as like this also, because current is equal to V bar divided by ZL bar. Okay, if I increase the frequency, XL will increase, then ZL will increase, then what will happen to my current? My current will reduce. Okay, my current will reduce. So my question is, why the current is getting reduced? When you increase the frequency, why the current is getting reduced? Okay, because once if you increase the frequency, where impedance increases, then current reduces. Why it is happening? Practically what is happening there? Okay, then why we are getting this nature? Okay, that is the question now. Okay, because we know these things already. Okay, XL means omega L, we know that. Or if ZL means j omega L, that we know. But why it is happening like this? Because if you see the basic properties of the inductor, okay, you are increasing the frequency of the inductor. Okay, once if you're increasing the frequency of the inductor, that means you are reducing the time period of the cycles. Okay, so what is happening? See, frequency you are increasing, time period you are reducing. That means you are forcing the inductor, because suppose again, you know already, the inductor cannot change the current instantaneously. Okay, so inductor cannot change the current instantaneously. So now already some frequency is there. Once if you increase the frequency, the time is reduced, and again say rest of the things are constant, like amplitude of the current is constant. Then once if you reduce the time, you are not providing the enough time for the flux change. Okay, you are not providing the enough time for the flux change. If there is no enough time for the flux change, the current cannot change. Okay, the current cannot change instantaneously. That's why the current value decreases. Okay, so what is happening when you increase the frequency? The time is getting reduced. Okay, that means there is no enough time to provide, no enough time enough time to provide flux variation. No, enough time to provide flux variation, because I already told you for the inductor to operate properly, there need the flux variation. You need the flux variation. Okay, if there is no enough time is given to vary the flux. Okay, so no enough time to provide flux variation. Okay, so if the flux is not varying properly, then current also will not vary. Okay, you are not allowing the current to vary properly suddenly. So then the current will decrease. Okay, the variation in the current will decrease because flux is not able to vary, because flux will not vary very fastly, because as you vary your frequency very fastly, you are not giving the enough time. So no enough time is provided to vary the flux. Okay, so the current will not vary properly. If the current is not varying properly, then the current value will reduce. That means, that's why if the current reduces, then what is happening? What is the idea? The impedance offered by the inductor increases. Impedance offered by the inductor increases. That is the idea. Okay, now what is the voltage, current and power nature in inductor? Okay, voltage, current and power nature. Okay, so first, this is the time axis. Again, here voltage, current and power comes. This is one cycle. Okay, so the first one I apply VL. Okay, this is the waveform of voltage across the inductor. Then what is the current? Okay, and once if the voltage is like this, okay, what could be the current? Okay, and again, somebody tell me in inductor which one will lead, which one will lag. Okay, if it is an inductor, voltage will lead, current will lag. Okay, current will lag. That means what? If the voltage starts here, the corresponding current will start here. Okay, the corresponding current will start here. Then it goes like this. Okay, it goes like this. Again, infinite cycles will be there. So it's no problem. You can complete this also. Okay, no problem. You can complete this. Okay, because infinite cycle is there. Okay, so you can complete this one. Okay, that's also same one. Okay, now for the first one is voltage, and then this one is current nature. This one is current nature IL. Okay, this is IL. Then what is the power nature here? Okay, you have to be a little bit careful here. See, if you observe in between this interval, voltage is having positive nature, but the current is having negative nature. Okay, you know the power means product of voltage and current. Okay, then finally the power will be in the negative cycle. Okay, the power will be in the negative cycle. So the power is going like this, because this is positive, this is negative, so finally negative. Next, I'll observe in between these two points. Now the voltage is positive, current also positive, so this will be going to the positive region. Next, I'll concentrate in between these two points. Now my voltage is negative, but the current is positive, so it will go to negative. Next, both voltage and current in the negative, so I will get the power as a positive. Okay, so in the same graph I have mentioned voltage, current as well as the power. Okay, but if you observe the power nature, finally the power here is negative. Okay, because in the first half cycle you are getting negative power, then positive power, and the negative positive, like that it keeps on varying. Okay, so plus power, minus power, plus minus, like that it comes. Okay, but if you see in this case the power is really positive. Okay, the power is only in the positive off cycle, so the power is really positive finally. But here the power is not positive, not negative, it is finally canceling out. Okay, so the positive power, negative power, positive power, negative power, something like that. Okay, then what is the observation from here? Okay, what is the power dissipated by the inductor? Either is it dissipating any power or not? That we have to analyze. Really, is it dissipating any power, or is it storing any power? That we have to analyze. Okay, so Okay, before that, and again, this power nature, okay, the power in the inductor is called as a lagging power, okay. Why it is lagging power? Okay, this power in the inductor is called as a lagging power. Okay, lagging, or, and again, this power will be denoted as a VAR, volt ampere reactive, that I will tell you later. Okay, so the power is lagging VAR, why? Volt ampere reactive. Okay, the power in inductor, okay, power in inductor is called as a lagging VAR. Okay, lagging in the sense, first what is happening in the first cycle, immediately what is happening, the power goes to negative, that's why this is called as a lagging VAR. Or otherwise, you can also tell this lagging with respect to current, because once in inductor, what is happening to I? I is always lagging, that's why the power in the inductor is also lagging. Okay, so whenever you provide the lagging nature for power, you can consider the current. Okay, what is happening to the current, then the same thing will happen to power. Okay, so the current is lagging, then the power will lag. Okay, so this is called as a lagging power, lagging power. Okay, then so the next question is, okay, what is the next question? Whether energy is stored in the inductor when AC is applied. Whether, because I told you already, the inductor can store the energy, but what is happening here? Whether it is it storing any energy? Whether the energy will be stored in inductor when AC signal applied. When AC signal applied. Okay, because the answer is no, you cannot store the energy. Why you cannot store the energy? Because in the positive off cycle, you are giving some energy. In the negative off cycle, you are giving the negative energy. Again, positive energy, negative energy. Like this, it's something like you are giving and taking. Okay, so what is happening to the inductor? Okay, the source is giving the power, and also it is taking, and again giving, and again taking. So finally, what will be there in the inductor? Nothing will be there. Finally, what will be there? Nothing will be there. So that means, when for an inductor, if you apply the AC signal, it cannot store the energy. It cannot store the energy, but it can provide some impedance. Okay, for the rest of the network, it will provide some impedance. Okay, so it cannot store the energy. It can store the energy under some other condition. Okay, so it can store the energy when you apply the DC signal. Okay, that means what? The inductor can store the energy when you apply the DC signal, but for AC signal, it cannot store the energy. It cannot store the energy. Okay, and the next, what is happening to the phasors? Okay, phasor, what is the relationship between the voltage and current in the inductor? Okay, already I told you, in inductor, which one will lead, which one will lag? Okay, the voltage will lead, the current will lag. Okay, so if I take this as a voltage axis, okay, and again, you may have a doubt, because VL leading means I have to put here. It's not like that, you can put anywhere, but that relationship has to be correct. Okay, it has to be in the correct format. Okay, why I am putting here VL here means, okay, so what is happening? This V is I am applying, whatever that I apply, that I will keep it as a reference. Okay, the same V is will be applied across the inductor also. Okay, so that means I will take this VL as a reference, that VL is same as what I have applied, V. Okay, then now my current has to lag. So I will put my current here. What is there? I will put my current. Okay, what is important? Always there should be 90 degree phase shift between the voltage and the current. And again, your current has to lag with respect to voltage. So what is the power factor here? Because power factor formula is always cos phi. Now what is angular is zero. Now the power factor is zero. Okay, that means really no energy is dissipated by the inductor, because the source is giving the energy and it is taking in return. It is giving and taking. Okay, finally nothing is dissipated by the inductor practically. Okay, actually really no energy is wasted by the inductor. Okay, so that it is indicating as a zero. Okay, zero energy. Okay, but you are giving and taking the energy. Yes, sir. Any doubt?
90 degree அப்படினா பவர் அப் சொல்லுங்க சார் 45 சைக்கிள்ல முன்ன ப்ரீவியஸ்
சொல்லுங்க 90 டிகிரில
சைக்கிள் வந்து 45 ம் 90 டிகிரி லேக் ன்னு சொல்றீங்களா சார்
ஆமா ஆமா ம்
ஓகே முன்னாடி எது வாங்க சார் சைக்கிள் வாங்க சார்
முன்னாடி சொல்லுங்க இதுலயா
ஆ ப்ரீவியஸ் சார்
ரெசிஸ்டர்ங்களா
சைக்கிள்ல எஸ் நெக்ஸ்ட் வா இன்டக்டர் சைக்கிள் வந்து 90 டிகிரி அப்படினும் போது பவர் கம்மி இல்ல சார் பவர் வரும் இல்லீங்களா இது 45 இருக்கும் போது தான் சார் பவர் ஆல்டர்னேட் டு 0 ஆகும்
45 இருக்கும் போது 0 ஆகும் இன்டக்டர்ல 90 வரும் போது 0 ஆகாதுன்றீங்களா
எஸ் சார் இப்போ இந்த சர்க்கிள் இப்படி வரும் இல்லீங்களா சார்
இல்ல இந்த டயகிராம்ல ஏதாவது டவுட் இருக்கா உங்களுக்கு
டயகிராம்ல கரெக்ட் சார் அப்போ 90 வரும் போது இங்க 45 தான் சார் நம்ம
எங்க 45 எடுத்து போறீங்க இந்த 45 எடுத்துக்கணும்ன்றீங்களா
45 நேரா சார் பவர் 0 ஆகும் 19 வரும்போது பவர் வரும்
எப்படி சொல்றீங்க 45 ல பவர் 0 வந்து காஸ் ஏதா ஃபார்முலா இருக்குங்களா ஓகே சார் நான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஓகே ஓகே சார் ஓகே ஃபர்ஸ்ட் நான் இத ப்ரோசீட் பண்றேன் அதுக்கு அப்புறம் பாத்துக்கலாம் சார் அடுத்த கிளாஸ்ல என்ன டவுட்னு பாத்துக்கலாம் ஓகே சோ whenever the phase difference is 90 degree the power factor is 0 the power dissipated by the inductor is zero but some work has been done okay some work has been done that I will clarify with some other example in the some other manner okay and okay so power factor here is zero at this moment you just try to know this value what is the power factor what is the formula later you will get the ideas practical ideas okay now the power factor is zero okay and what is this meaning of this one okay what is this meaning say and finally the confusion here is okay when I have a voltage source when I connect to the resistance it is simply dissipating the power into the heat but the same voltage source when I apply to the inductor it is not dissipating but something is happening here it is giving the energy and in return it is going there finally the power once if you calculate the real power dissipated real power is zero but some other power will be there that is called as a reactive power okay reactive power okay but there is no real power here some other power is wasted here that power is called as a reactive power that's why whenever we write the power across the inductor okay in a notation volt ampere reactive because that power is not a real power reactive power okay simply I will give you the example of this one okay say the first case is something similar to now that your voltage source is like your parent okay your parent okay once if they give the money to you what you will do something you will do you may spend or you may not spend okay no need to give it back okay you can utilize fully or in the second case I can assume like you are getting money from the bank okay once if you get the money from the bank it is something like now your nature is like an inductor when you get the money from the bank your nature is like an inductor when you get the money from your parent your nature is like a resistance okay but once if you get the money from the bank you can utilize it but you have to return it back and again you may think what is the work done here something you got you returned ultimately what is the amount given by the bank to you at the end of the day is zero but it doesn't mean that this process is useless but okay again you are having here some useful process because with that money you have done something you might have completed your education something else it's something similar to that when you have a inductor the real power dissipated is zero but there is some reactive power spent okay so why what is the need of this reactive power okay because to control the other part of the circuit we will be using this power okay to control the other part of the circuit but actual power will be going across the resistance because in reality okay when you have a voltage source you will have a resistance as well as you will have a inductor okay so real power will be dissipated across this but in order to have some control over the circuit we'll be using L because by varying the L I can control the current okay so to control the circuit we'll be using the inductor but the no energy will be dissipated across the inductor but source point of view it has to do some extra work because it has to give the again because it is charging and discharging no so it is doing some work Okay, so source point of view, it is giving two kind of power, P plus Q. That P goes to R, Q goes to L. Okay, that's why the source power is called a complex power. S is equal to P plus Q. Okay, so when you have this nature, resistance as well as inductor, the real power will be dissipated by the resistance. Okay, now the across the inductor, there is no real power, but some power will be there. That power is called a reactive power. That power is called reactive power. That reactive power is used to control the circuit. Okay, used to control the circuit, because once if you vary L, I will vary, and again your reactive power will vary. Again here S also may vary. Okay, so that is the idea. This is real power. This is the reactive power. And again the question is, can we use R instead of L? Only R, because you need if you need a control over the circuit, you need L also. Okay, so then there is no other way to go. You have to use in combination, R in series with the L, or R in parallel with the L, something like that you have to introduce. Because once if you use a very heavy equipment and all, whether you like it or not, that L nature or C nature will come automatically. Okay, L nature or C nature will come automatically. Then you have to worry about everything. What is complex power? What is real power? What is reactive power? Okay, the another name for this power, complex power, is called apparent power. Apparent power. Okay, another name for complex power is like a apparent power. Okay, the power P is called real power. Okay, real power. The notation is watt. Okay, so finally, we are having three types of power. S is equal to P plus JQ. Okay, so this is for R. This is for L or C. Okay, and again this is common, in common. Now here the simply this is the ratio of, this is the source voltage and how much current is going from the source, V bar, I bar. Okay, because this is like a supply. Okay, some complex power you are supplying. Okay, some part of that going to as a real power, remaining part going as a reactive power. Okay, so this is called as complex power, this is called as real power, this is called as reactive power. Okay, so the complex power unit is volt ampere, this unit is watt, this unit is volt ampere reactive. Ultimately all are same, because you know, as per the notation point of view, power is equal to power plus power only. But in order to differentiate whether that is real or reactive or complex, we are using different unit. Okay, we are using different unit. Okay, so this is the idea here. Okay, now we'll see the nature of the capacitor in the next class. If you have any doubt, you can ask now. The recording can be stopped.